everyone, my name is Charity and welcome to my YouTube channel. Here's the thing, I have a moisturizing routine or moisturizing schedule and I will leave the video in the description. So typically after I have washed my hair, say I washed my hair on Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, I need to moisturize my hair. Because at that point, my hair needs some love, basically. So last week, I had washed my hair on Saturday. Thursday, I moisturized my hair. I do the LOC method. And so I use my water bottle and I spritz each section with water. And I typically just like do it in my palm. I spritz each section with water. And then I add a little bit of coconut oil. And I typically keep it in this applicator bottle. I will often melt it in hot water, collect hot water in here, and then I'll put the coconut oil in here, and that's how it melts. I don't allow it to run under hot water because that's a lot of water that's being wasted. On a Thursday, I decided that I was gonna skip the oil part. So all I did was that I applied water to each section. I had quite a bit of twists in my hair. I do have my earpieces in because I was listening to something when I was taking up my twist. Just FYI. I decided I was going to skip the oil part and then just apply the water and apply my homemade shea butter mix. And this I have cocoa butter, shea butter, sweet almond oil, and coconut oil in here. And so it's very moisturizing, by the way. I use it on my skin too. So technically I should have washed my hair on Saturday, but I had a lot of things going on, so I decided to push it to Monday. I typically wash my hair within 7 to 10 days. I have to wash my hair. Monday will be day 9. And so I just wanted to take out my twists because they looked old. As soon as I took out the first twist, I was like, oh my goodness. My hair felt so soft. It does not feel dry at all. It still feels really, really moisturized. I was just like, oh my goodness, I need to tell y'all. Just wanted to just talk about the importance of moisturizing your hair, ladies. That is one of the best ways to retain length to your hair, because if your hair is dry, your hair is not going to get long. Because if your hair is dry, your hair is going to just become brittle and it'll just break. Please put yourself on a hair moisturizing schedule, okay? Just remember, the principle is that every 3 to 4 days, your hair needs to be taken care of. Your hair is kind of like a plant. Just remember that your hair is a plant that needs water every few days. I used to feel very uncomfortable with applying water to my hair when it wasn't wash day because I felt like, I don't want to put water in my hair. But then I realized that my hair does need water and I need to really start getting comfortable with giving it what it needs in order for it to thrive. Actually, as I was filming this video, my mom was calling me. We were talking on FaceTime and she was like, oh, I think that your hair has grown more. And I was like, you know what? Yeah, I think so too, because a few years ago, maybe like 2 or 3 years ago, honestly, I really didn't care much about my hair. My relationship with my hair was kind of like, it was basically non-existent. I would wash it when needed to be washed, you know, but in terms of like really paying a little bit more attention to it, I really wasn't doing that. Last year, I really actually started to pay more attention to my hair and I started to just focus more on it. And I realized that like I've seen a lot of improvement in my hair. And one of the things that I did differently that I continue to do is moisturizing my hair and putting my hair on a moisturizing schedule. I wash my hair on Saturday, for example. 3 or 4 days later, I go back into my hair, I spritz my scalp with water, and then I typically seal with coconut oil. Coconut oil is my favorite oil for my hair. I also spritz water onto the hair strands themselves and then seal that with coconut oil and my cream. But like I said, this time I really didn't do the cream, the oil thing. I just did the cream and my hair feels so soft. So I feel like I want to just keep trying this and see how it really turns out in the future. Almost 3 years ago, I relocated from New York to Texas. When I first came to Texas, I was like, what is going on with my scalp? My scalp would be so dry. I would wash my hair and a few days afterward, I would see like flakes in my scalp, like serious flakes, because the summers here are really, really hot. I knew that it was the weather because I had never been in such an extreme weather before. So I definitely knew that it was the weather. So I definitely started praying, like, Lord, I need help. Like I really need help for my hair. What can I do? And then I found a YouTube video, and I actually have already talked about this in another video, but I'll just repeat it for emphasis sake. So I found this lady on YouTube. She was talking about how to moisturize your scalp to prevent dryness. And I basically followed that method. Like, I kid you not, till this day, I have not seen that dryness. It's gone. And that is just because, number one, did something differently. I actually got comfortable with applying water directly to my scalp when it wasn't wash day. Implemented a scalp moisturizing schedule. Basically, what she did was that she would spritz her scalp with water, and then she would seal that with oil, seal the moisture into her scalp, and then that was it. And I started doing that, and that was such a game changer for me. It really transformed my hair. If you are struggling with dry scalp, you might want to try this. Whenever you wash your hair, 3 days after you've washed your hair, go into your scalp, get a spray bottle, spritz it into your scalp, seal it with an oil. Use a light oil. Don't use like a heavy oil, a light oil like coconut oil or olive oil. Seal that moisture into your scalp and restyle your hair if that is necessary. Let me know if that helps, because I'm telling you, that really helped, and I'm really grateful, and I believe God led me to her video because I was praying around that time. I even, like, I was looking up like solutions on Google, and you know, somehow I came across like apple cider vinegar rinses, and I even tried that and that didn't work. Really give God praise, and I really thank the lady who made the video. I really actually like commented on one of her videos, and I told her thank you. I'll leave the link to that video in the description so you can watch me explain basically everything. I wanted to share with you all how soft my hair feels. I'm supposed to be washing my hair tomorrow, by God's grace. So after work, the plan is to wash my hair. I also try just using the cream as part of my moisturizing routine rather than like doing the oil, and see if that really gives me that consistent softness over time, because I really would like to know if my hair will remain soft, you know. Like, I literally have to wash my hair tomorrow, but my hair just feels awesome. It really, honestly, it does. Like, it almost feels like I don't even need to wash my hair. I know I need to wash my hair because my scalp is a little bit itchy. And yeah, that's like my sign for, okay, it's time to wash my hair. It doesn't matter how good the hair looks. It's time to be washed. It's time to be washed. Okay. People really ask like, oh, what products do you use and all these things? And I always say I'm not about the products, and I really am not. I don't like it when people focus so much on products, because honestly, long hair is not about the products. Long hair is about, let me tell you a few. There are 4 T's, okay? 4 T's for having long hair, long, naturally curly hair. Okay, there are tools, okay? So tools such as a wide tooth comb, okay? Tools such as like these spray bottles, tools such as like these applicator bottles, tools such as hair clips. You know, there are certain tools that you need, okay? There are certain techniques, okay? So techniques in that, in terms of like with your styling, protective styling, hiding the ends of your hair so you don't want your ends overly exposed, because that can cause you to have breakage of the ends of your hair. Tools, techniques, tips. Tips are like me telling you like, okay, if you really want to prevent breakage, then stop combing your hair dry. You have to stop combing your hair dry. Right now, I'm not gonna put a comb on this hair. Absolutely not. The only time I'm gonna put on a comb on this hair is tomorrow, by God's grace, when I am actually about to detangle after I've washed it and there's conditioner in this hair. Right now, I am not going to put a comb. I'm gonna pull it back in some sort of an updo just so that I can go to work tomorrow. Wear a satin bonnet to sleep or a satin pillowcase to sleep. You know, those are all tips that help. And then also time. That's your last T. So tools, techniques, tips, and time. You need to spend time with your hair. You need to be willing to spend time with your hair. time is an investment, right? Everything that we do, if we want to be successful, we have to invest time into it. And so if you want your hair to be long, you have to be willing to spend time with your hair. That means that you have to be willing to spend time to learn how to properly wash your hair, how to detangle your hair, how to moisturize your hair, how to deep condition your hair. All of that requires time. And if you're not willing to sacrifice time for your hair, then I'm not really quite sure that you're ready for long hair. Just remember the four T's of long hair attainment. Remember once again, tools, techniques, tips, and time. All right, you all. So like I said, this is a very unplanned video, but I just wanted to come on and just share that with you all. It's been good. Like, I like this. This is kind of like really nice where I can just kind of sit and chit chat. Thank you all so much for all of your support. You know, a lot of you send a lot of really, really, really nice comments and your messages are very, very encouraging. Thank you all so much for your continued support. Also, let me know if you're interested in a Q&A. Do you want to see a natural hair Q&A? I can do that for you. I can answer your questions, whatever questions you have about my hair or about natural hair in general. I can do that. And then also, are you interested in like a faith Q&A, right? Because I'm a Christian, I'm a born again Christian, and that's a really, really, really big part of my life. So are you interested in like a Q&A about that? Are you interested in a Q&A on modesty or on nursing? So I'm a registered nurse, and so I do have a Facebook group for the nursing aspect of me as well as the natural hair aspect. And so yeah, let me know. I would like to do a Q&A for you all. If you all are interested, you can send me your questions. You can write your questions in the description, or if you follow me on Facebook, you can DM me your questions. If you have questions about faith, modesty, nursing, please let me know, and I would love to bring you all a video answering all of your questions. Thank you all so much for watching the video today. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and please share and subscribe. Have a blessed week. Stay safe. Be prayerful. Focus on God at this time, this pandemic and everything else that's going on. Focus on the Lord and, you know, meditate on His word and allow Him to pull you closer to Him, you know, because that is what He desires most, is to get to know us and we get to know Him, and He reveals great things unto us, and that's a wonderful thing. All right, so I will talk to you all in the next video.